Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do your daily vibes for whenever it resonates. So this could be tomorrow, could be today, could be next week, right? Because the timing is fluid. We're all at different spots in our journey. This reading may or may not be for you. I can't read for every single person every single day, so just take what resonates and leave the rest. So what do we have for the upcoming energy? What kind of message do I need to deliver today? What I see is the Nine of Wands, which is somebody that is facing a bunch of life challenges. Life is challenging right now. And it's like finding all that strength that you can to get through this challenge. So it's very challenging. And maybe it's about independence, because I really feel like it is. Something about independence. The challenge is giving up independence or becoming independent. Also, when you see the Nine of Wands, there's, you know, somebody that has been avoiding challenge. If it's in the reverse, it's like, yeah, life hasn't been easy. Life has been hard. And there could be some hard feelings. There could be some anger, you know, angry about all the strife life has thrown your way. But it's those times where you find your ability to stand up and take ownership for your part in it, and you gain strength, you gain knowledge through those situations. It really builds your character. So anyway, I don't know where all this is coming from, but I feel like we have somebody here that is really having a hard time. They're struggling, really struggling with life. You know what I mean? It just feels like with life, it's like it's such a challenge, but it's not. I mean, it is. Yes, it's a challenge. Now we get the Ten of Wands, which is right after the Nine, which is overwhelming. Okay, that's overwhelming. That's, you know, too much. There's too much. Somebody is too busy. They have too many demands. Now that when you see the Ten of Wands, it's like, it's heavy. There's some sort of heaviness. This is really, really too much. So we definitely have somebody that is struggling, feeling overwhelmed, carrying a heavy burden, carrying a heavy weight, feeling alone as well. It's like it feels like this person has brought on this feeling. They have brought on this heaviness. They've brought it on to themselves. They chose it. They chose to carry this burden. They chose to go down this path. Now they got to take ownership, okay? Because the Nine of Wands is about taking ownership. Now, when you get to, and this came out, so it's a challenge to let go. When a card comes out sideways, it means it's a challenge. It's a challenge to let go of things that don't serve you, because for some reason they have some sort of importance. I don't know why. So somebody Nine of Wands is a card of challenge, and this came out as a challenge. So we have somebody here that needs to let go of something. Maybe it's weight. Maybe it's dead weight. Maybe it's baggage. Maybe it's a job that is weighing them down. Maybe it is guilt. It feels like we have somebody here that has reached the point of collapse with the Ten of Wands. This is like the point of collapse. It's like you have to let something go. It's not serving you. It's killing you. Something has to go. It's like balance is waiting, but you have to get something off your back. So somebody maybe need to get something off their back. Maybe it's killing them. Maybe they're holding it in. Maybe they got to say something. You got to get it off your back. It's killing you. So there's something stressful that is hurting somebody, and they need to get it off their back. However that resonates with you. Okay. Wands are about passion. So it's something that this person is very passionate about. It's like, and I feel like there's some, it's like, it's going to kill you. And you know, just get it off your back. Maybe you got to say something. That's what I want to say. You've got to say something. Seven of Wands. Now, the Seven of Wands is also a challenge card. It's opposition. It's stiff competition. It's caught off guard. It's refusing to budge. We have a big, this is a competition. We have somebody that is highly competitive here. Very competitive. Takes a lot of risks. This is about accepting a challenge. So, I'll put it right here. It's like they're thinking about it. You notice they're thinking about going in. They're about ready to go in, but it is definitely a challenge. So, yeah, we got this. There's a challenge coming up. Ooh, Seven of Swords reversed. Seven of Swords reversed is getting caught. Now we have two sevens. So this is getting caught. Somebody has been lying. They haven't been telling the truth. This one's going right here, and that's what's killing them. Somebody's not owning up to something. They're not telling the truth. They're not being honest, and they may not be being honest with themselves. This person doesn't seem to be being honest with themselves. It's like they're lying to themselves, and it's like, I think this person isn't sleeping. I think this person is really, really, really struggling. Really struggling. Struggling to tell the truth, probably wanting to obviously get something, needs to get something off their back that they were not honest about. Queen of Cups reverse. It's a very emotional time. It's very emotional. Now, the Queen of Cups in reverse is somebody who has shut down emotionally. Okay, this is somebody who has no more love to offer. There's no love left. The love has died. Okay, the love has died. It's like there's deep sadness. Somebody's been heartbroken. There's a disappointment. Okay, so we have somebody here that is very disappointed and heartbroken and sad and, isn't emotionally available anymore. Now, the Queen of Cups in reversed has probably grown cold. She's probably grown cold. She's taken her love away, right? So we could have somebody that is overwhelmed because the love has died. The love is gone. But there was some deception. There was a reason why the love died. There was. The Devil. Now, the Devil reversed is taking back control. But things have gotten worse. Things have gotten worse. Now, the Queen of Cups in reverse could be somebody that is a liar. This is a gossip. This is somebody that is hypersensitive, is wishy-washy, is clingy, is needy, is jealous. Can also be a person that is very fantasy-based, you know, has a hard time accepting reality. So this is somebody who doesn't accept reality well, may use drugs or alcohol or something to bury their feelings or something like that. But this is, and so there could be some addictions here, but the Devil is about taking back control. Things have gotten worse. Now the Devil in reversed is suffering. We have somebody here that is really, really, really suffering. And I think they're suffering over a love. Okay. It's like the love is lost. Love is gone. Love has died. They lied. They deceived because of that Seven of Swords. And somebody may have gotten caught in lies, because that is getting caught in lies. Not sure if it's a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, or a Capricorn, but there's somebody getting caught. They're getting caught. Now, the Devil reversed is freedom. It's breaking free. Somebody's been in a deep, dark place, very, very dark, and there's been a lot of anxiety and depression there, and it's not getting any better. And they're probably dealing with a bitch. Somebody that uses emotional blackmail as a tactic to, you know, stay on top, because the Seven of Wands is about staying on top. It's definitely a very challenging time. We have somebody that is very stressed out. King of Wands. King of Wands reversed. Could be dealing with an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Now, this person, is very controlling, can be naive. This person can be naive in the reversed. I need to get one more card to see what this guy is. This guy is unreasonable. He's being unreasonable in some way. He may be mad. He may be mad. He may be upset. The King of Wands in reverse is somebody who is upset. Nine of Pentacles reversed. Now, this guy is losing stability, losing security, not wanting to be alone, feeling alone. So this guy is feeling very alone. Maybe losing money. Maybe a loss of money. We could have somebody here that is experiencing financial loss. Or they're going to experience some sort of financial loss. Or they're not seeing something clearly. I mean, the Nine of Coins reversed is somebody that needs to have discipline. They need to find their strength and they need to find their self-confidence to break free from something, because this is break free. So we do have a person here that is, you know, maybe scared. The King of Wands may be scared. He's scared to break free from, I don't know if it's this woman or who this person is. This person is, you know, very emotional, cries a lot, bitches, bitch, lies a lot, very deceptive. So we do have somebody here that lies a lot, okay? And it could be this person, but they both could lie. There could be some serious lies here. This could be a big, huge lying mess, put it that way. It really could. We have lies and we have deception and we have somebody that uses emotions as a tool, you know, they use their emotions as their tool to get what they want. We do have somebody here that is absolutely overwhelmed and probably sick of it. Very sick of it. It's like it's, what is this? King of Wands reversed. Four of Wands. Six of Coins. I'm just going to get a couple more and then I'm going to... Eight of Swords. So we have somebody that has been trapped. They have been trapped. They've been trapped in their thoughts. They've probably been trapped in fear. Okay? They've been trapped in fear. Trapped in fear of maybe fear of commitment. Maybe they're fearful of commitment. Or they're fearful of going through the gates. They're fearful of going through that new door. Because this is a going through a new door. They probably have a match, okay? There's probably a match. I wonder if we're dealing, maybe we're dealing with an Aries here. But anyway, I feel like there's a match. It's like there's a match made in heaven, but we have fear. So yes, there is some sort of fear. It doesn't have to be an Aries if you're dealing with anybody. We have somebody that is, it's like they're getting what they deserve, because the Six of Pentacles is about getting what you deserve. Give and take, generosity, a gift. So it's like they're being given a gift. They're being given a gift of some sort, but it's like they can't see it. They can't see it. And I'm not sure why they can't see it, because they're stuck. They won't open their eyes. They won't open their eyes. They're stuck in fear. They're trapped in fear. They're trapped in fear of commitment, fear of something, fear of giving away, fear of giving up their independence. So we do, or becoming independent. It could go either way. So I feel like we have a man, and I think it is a man that is fearful. He's probably very upset. He's angry. He's angry for some reason, or he's cold, or he could be. I mean, the King of Wands in reverse is somebody that is self-centered and somebody that is unreasonable. This is somebody that could be very egotistical, has a really big ego. This person is afraid of, you know, society rules this guy in reverse. What's everybody going to say? What if I make a mistake? So he's fearful of making a mistake for fear of what everybody else is going to say. But this is getting caught. So this is getting caught, fear of getting caught. And maybe he's fearful of getting caught from this person. Maybe he has another opportunity. you know? Another, and it's a perfect match, but he's fearful. Now, this is freedom breaking free. The devil reverse. So there's an opportunity to break free from some toxic, unhealthy situation. So we do have a King of Wands that may be breaking free from somebody that doesn't reciprocate love or doesn't love them or something like that. Fights with them all the time. I gotta take them now, don't I? Eight of Coins reverse. That's giving up. Ten of Pentacles. Knight of Coins reversed. Justice reversed. And the Ten of Swords reversed. So we have somebody here that is giving up. They are giving up. It's like they can't do it anymore. They don't have anything left to prove. They don't want to put in effort, so they're giving up. There could be the end of a relationship. Tens are completions, okay? So this is the end of a family legacy, or it's the end of a relationship, or there's a change in the family dynamics, or there's a change in the home. Now, the Ten of Pentacles is a completion that leads to stability, okay? The Ten of Pentacles leads to abundance. It does. But it's after a completion of some sort. It's like, you notice this one's sticking out. So there's a golden opportunity. There's an opportunity for success. But it looks like you have to stop doing something that you've been doing. So somebody has to put the brakes on a situation. They're probably dealing with somebody who doesn't put in any effort. The Knight of Pentacles is somebody that is unfaithful, somebody that is jealous, somebody that is lazy and unhealthy, somebody that isn't really qualified. And, you know, they need to stop dealing with that person. They need to break free from that person, whoever that person is. I feel like we got somebody that wastes money as well. They spend money like water. So, you know, it's like they don't even realize what they're doing. So this person could be getting upset because of that. Now, this justice reversed is karma, okay? It's karma. So there could be a financial loss here. It feels like there could be. Something is definitely coming to an end because we have three tens. 10, 10, 10. So something is coming to an end. Something that has been, you notice this guy's on the ground too. It's been painful. Really, 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 really painful. There's been a delay. There's been a delay in this ending, but I think we have somebody here that has reached the end. They've reached rock bottom. It's like, I can't do this anymore. Somebody has definitely been lying. There's been an injustice. They have. There's been some unfair treatment. Somebody didn't want to be held accountable. They weren't telling the truth. And now they're overwhelmed because it's like it's eating them alive. It's like they're eating it, whatever has happened. It's like they know that they're dealing with somebody that is very deceptive. They're knowing that they're dealing with a liar. And now it's like the plague. It's like they're just, it's killing them. It's killing them. It's like they can't do this anymore. There's been some sort of terrible treatment or terrible injustice. We have somebody here that has been placing blame. You know, they've been blaming somebody else for everything when it takes two. So I feel like whatever this is, this is. The Six of Pentacles is taking and giving to somebody else. You reap what you sow. So this is receiving a new relationship. There could be somebody here that is receiving a new opportunity with the Four of Wands. The Four of Wands is great happiness. The minute you go through that new doorway, the minute you go down that new path, there's an opportunity to build a new foundation here or to step into happiness. I mean, the Four of Wands, it's like you go through those gates and it is beautiful. So there is an opportunity for happiness, but we have somebody here that is fearful. It's like they lack self-confidence as well. So I think this person lacks confidence. And they may even be fearful of rejection. Somebody may be fearful. There's definite fear here. There's somebody here that is trapped in fear of giving something away, giving up their independence. It's like, yeah, it's safe. It's safe. It's safe where I'm at. It's safe. So they're fearful of stepping outside of the safety zone. I think there's going to be a change in home, okay? A change in residence or the change in the family dynamics. Somebody is dealing with an individual who doesn't love them. Okay? I'm sorry. But, you know, it's like, it is not fair. Yeah, it's not fair. It's terrible. It's terrible. And I think that we have somebody here that is struggling to deal with this challenge of, you know, taking the swords out of their back and dropping this person and going down that new path, okay? Because I feel like it's stress. Some stressful situations, like stress kills, and that's just something I need to reiterate. We have somebody here that is very, very, very stressed. Now, this is, we get the Ten of Swords in reversed. Something could be coming back from the dead, okay? It could be. It died a long time ago, and this person has got something that they need to get off their back. They need to get it off their back because they know they did something wrong. So somebody could be, you know, saying something. But they're definitely fearful and they're being challenged. They are probably being challenged by karma to do so. Now, this is bad luck and bad karma. So I feel like we have somebody here that is experiencing bad karma and they keep on having one downfall after another. They do. They do. And it keeps happening because they need to get that off their back. Maybe they need to apologize. I don't know. It feels like somebody has to stop, give, or somebody didn't put in effort. Somebody didn't put in effort. They didn't treat another person fairly. There's been some unfair treatment here. We have a lot of pentacles here. I think that there's money issues. So that could be where the karma is lying. Somebody's experiencing money woes. Karma will often hit you right in the pocketbook. So somebody is losing money, or they are, you know, something. They're having a lot of setbacks that are costing them money. There could be some upcoming legal issues that cost some money. Somebody could get sued. They could get sued because, you know, karma works in mysterious ways. So anyway, we do have this King of Wands up here. This King of Wands is somebody that gets angry and upset. And that he could get very frustrated and there could be like a blow up. There could be a blow up. But the good part here is this Four of Wands. So the Four of Wands can be, happiness, okay? The Four of Wands is happiness. It's contentment. It's a gathering or it's a commitment. So somebody may, the Six of Pentacles, they may decide that they do want a commitment, but there's a lot of fear. There's a lot of fear. So something about commitment and happiness and home. There could be an upcoming gathering. This could be a gathering. Somebody could be going to a gathering in the next 4 or 5 days, 4 to 6 days. Some sort of gathering. You know, this could be not surviving the Ten of Swords reversed. It could be. It's like, I don't know what is going on here, but this could be some sort of addiction. So I'm not sure what is going with the devil as well. Reversed. The devil reversed is a severe addiction. So, but I do feel like we have freedom because the devil reversed is freedom and these tens are freedom. Freedom from something. And I think it has to do with a family situation. Freedom from something that is unhealthy and toxic and has weighed you down for a long time. So it's a time of freedom and finding happiness. So I think that happiness is coming. It's because if you think about the Six of Pentacles, it's exchanging one for the other. So I do feel like there's going to be some sort of exchange where somebody lets go, the devil reversed, of something that is toxic and unhealthy. It's like unrequited love. And they head towards a perfect match because if you notice, it's a perfect match. So, yeah, I feel like somebody has been fearful of giving up their independence or fearful of becoming independent, but something is about to change with all these tens. I do also feel like somebody has been being really dishonest. They've been lying. And they know it's a lie. And the fact that they know it's a lie is killing them. And my advice is to get it off your back so you can breathe a sigh of relief. Good luck.